watched his interview, you'll understand why.
Yes.
I really am a hacker. I'm just a biohacker.
Yeah. All right, John. Nice. See
you. Absolutely.
Nice. Bye-bye. Nice meeting you.
Thank you.
Yeah, can you shoot the badges quickly so we can roll?
David, I'm rolling.
About to melt in the sun.
I'm melting.
Yes, right, I'm melting. We just walked four miles to go the wrong way.
Hello, Irene.
Hello, how are you?
I need to find a good foot job.
I am Will.
Oh, like a rubber tug or just a foot massage?
Okay, who's going to be? I'll be in the middle so I can mic both of you.
Line, yes. See that line right there? Use that as your marker.
We're back here.
We're back there?
Yeah.
Cool.
So this way I can play with the zoom. Otherwise, I can't zoom too much.
Now, here's a good angle for this. If you, is this like for an acting
site?
Yeah.
Exactly.
So, how many actors are aspiring filmmakers?
Perspiring or aspiring?
Both.
There's some perspiring. Okay. Yes. There are careers perspiring, but in general, they're all they want to be filmmakers. No.
I would think most of them not only want to be filmmakers, they want to be the producer, the director, and the leading role.
Well, if that's the case, like
we are you rolling right now?
Are we?
Okay. Cool.
Yeah. Okay.
We can only
B-roll
pickup.
But there's an indie circuit out there that needs a light that we created. It's called Illuminator. And
who are you? Do I know you?
My name's Steve Grillo, and I work for Brightshot.com.
I was actually going to get to that. Hi, I'm Kirk Kelly. We're back at NAB 2012, and we're with the people who have invented some new lighting technology, as well as have another side interest with a production company. Maybe we can get them to talk about both. But Stephen Grillo, who has also notoriously worked with the infamous Howard Stern, and Irene Conrad, no relation to Chuck?
No, not that Chuck Conrad. No.
Just checking. Okay, so you formed these two companies?
Yes. I have two partners, and Peter Ticton and Roy McDonald, and they're both the developers of the Illuminator.
Okay, and that's what you were just starting to talk about when I so eloquently cut you off. Tell me about the Illuminator.
I think you're coming on to me, pal. What's up?
No, it's just my feet are killing me, and I'm looking for a good foot job. Do you know of any?
Yeah, we'll talk later about that one. It is Vegas, pal.
And what stays here? Never mind.
Yes. Well, we developed a new LED light that basically runs on 3.8 amps, so you don't use 220. And there's a lot of aspects that anybody know who the lights, the big lights, the HMI lights, they run on 220 amps of power, and you have to find separate electric to run it to these lights, and it's a lot of electricity. So this is runs on 3.8 amps. You can fit five of them on a power strip and plug it into a 100 regular socket. So you're already cutting out electric down by a percent, I don't know, but it's a significant amount of electricity, on top of the fact that you're not running an air conditioner.
So this is actually much more green, and I get the impression, for those who are more techie oriented, that you're putting out equal or higher lumens and floor lamps for people to use.
It's the most powerful LED out there. We make a white light and a color light, and our color light has special effects built in, so it's a workhorse light. It can do anything. If there's a police scene, we have police lights. Old police car, new police car, ambulance, old, new.
So you literally could make, okay, here is a very glowing orange sunset on Malibu Bay. You could create that light.
Exactly. We can put daylight on the talent's face and put the background of the police lights with the same one light.
So this light we have right now is actually a light you guys provided today?
We did provide that light today. It's provided by Brightshot. You can look up us on brightshot.com. We provide the sunlight here in Vegas.
Yes, very nice. Yes. So I'm going to sidetrack for just a second. We'll come back. Howard Stern, tell me something.
What could I say? It was one of the most fun parts of my life to date. I worked.
You dated Howard Stern?
To date? No, it was like a marriage. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, he told me what to do and yelled at me, and I put my head down and I did it.
How long were you with Howard when you had your? Never mind.
Yes, he was a secret president of NAMBLA, the North American Man Boy Love Association.
And talk about private parts.
Yes.
So you worked with Howard for about a decade?
Almost a decade. I left right around 98, 99. I was lucky enough to fact that he did dedicate his book, Miss America, to me, which is a very, very very incredible honor. Still to this day, I don't think about going into a library and looking up a book that's dedicated to me. It's kind of freaky.
Wow, and it's called Mrs. America?
Miss America.
Oh, Miss America.
He was single then. We were just dating.
I see. Yeah. Very, very nice. So how did you find this unique individual?
Oh, I think it was the Munger factor.
Yeah.
We have a friend, a mutual friend, and we've hired Steve for promotions for both of our companies. And he knows how to drag. He's got a hook. He can get anybody to talk to him. And that's what he's the best at. And he brings people into our facility so we demo the light for them, and he just keeps bringing them in. David Letterman and the Jay Leno show he's about to do, Conan O'Brien, yeah.
I'm getting my foot in all the big doors, and every lighting director that's seen this light has said, I'll give you 5 minutes, and they spend 45 minutes.
Now, I want you to take a look at his foot that he gets in the door, because these are some pretty cool-looking foots.
These are my favorite shoes of all time. These are special edition Yoda Adidas.
Oh,
as you can
Yodas.
Tell, Master Yoda on the back, and we have Yoda on the tongue.
Hold on, what did you say?
Was that a little smelly? I'm not sure.
No, they're
cool. Oh, my.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh.
I take very good care of my feet and my sneakers, but I'm from the 80s. I grew up with Adidas and fat laces, so I found a really nice pair of green fat laces to don my Adidas, which should always have fat laces on it.
And this is how he's getting his foot in the door to get the green effervescent light, the nature look?
It's the very, classy kind of approach he has to talking
Jedi,
to people.
It's a Jedi mind trick. They're Yoda sneakers. You will let me in the door.
So you're being used on sets at CBS, NBC.
No, we're demoing them. We're a brand new company.
How new?
Brand new. We haven't sold. We're about to. We just finished our first run and about to sell. Up until we've been in R&D for a couple of years. It's a very unique item which can do everything. So.
Can do everything. I like that. How's it at foot massages? So
good, really good.
Attachments.
Nice. Yeah. Low, medium, and so you have these devices that you have put together, the lights, and you're at your first NAB presenting this product.
Actually, we've been here for a couple of years.
Presenting this product?
Prototype. And now we have our real light.
Okay, so you have your real light. You've been here before. How is it different this year over other years?
I don't know that it's so different. We're very proud of the fact that it's done and ready and that there are no issues anymore and that we can just sell it. So that's different. We're chomping at the bit, ready to run and sell and...
The first 40 just came off the assembly line about a week and a half ago. So, and they wouldn't, they kept going back to the drawing board. It took, almost, 2 years because they wanted to get it exactly where it was supposed to be. And now it is. And now we're so super psyched. Like, people are loving it.
So, cost effectiveness on the electric bill, obviously, but cost effectiveness in the original acquisition price?
I'm not sure what your question is. But
the original?
The original acquisition price, like, to buy this, it's going to cost me this versus buying someone else's light.
Oh, well, the reason that it costs $8,500 is because it does so many things. It's still, of course, there are discounts for larger things. If we're filling a whole studio with them, a grid and a whole studio, it's going to cost you less, but that's our list price.
But overall, the $8,500 for what you're getting and what you're saving in electricity is actually a very good cost-effective price point.
You'll make your money back on it just based on your electric, but and this is where it could possibly have some issues. It takes away some man hours, so you're able to save money from people running special cords, people in charge of air conditioning. The timing and the setup for a lighting director to get where he wants to is so quick, and you're actually able to use it on your iPad. It's iPad controllable. You can save all your settings forever on iTunes.
But what about my Android?
Well, Android too.
Okay,
yeah.
Just checking. So it sounds like being business visionary that. This is also going to help from an insurance standpoint because there's less liability of someone slip tripping, falling, or getting electrocuted, or
burning themselves. People burn themselves. Our light has practically no heat. You could put after 3 hours, you could put your face on it like this. There's no heat coming from it, so you're not filling a room with heat.
The thing is so hot that they can't touch it for an hour after they unplug it. It's turned off, and with gloves, you still can't touch it. So.
So do these come with Velcro or like really free covers so when I put my face next to it?
Yeah, it comes in rabbit fur, mink, and baby seal.
Actually, foo fur for PETA, and those are a concern. That's foo fur.
Yeah, so it just carries a lot of work. It's not just what about the light is, about what it does. You know, it's the future of the lights, because every studio is going to have to change to LED.
And
you can't keep up.
To go green needs to do this. I mean, and everybody wants to. Everybody's going to be mandated to.
We hope. So what's the production plant arm of your organization?
We're a post-production facility in New York on Broadway in Tribeca. Beautiful facility, and we do editing, audio and video editing for television.
It's our home base.
So it's also probably a showcase for your new lights, I'm guessing.
Yeah, we have a nice little area set up, and I've had some. We've had people from Blue Bloods down there to look at the light, and was it Damages? They were shooting outside, and I just went downstairs. I dragged somebody up. I said, "Give me 5." They stayed for 45 because they thought the light was a home run.
So his new slug line will be, "Give me 5, and you'll give me 45.
Right.
I like that. I'm going to write that on a T-shirt.
Yes. So in the long haul, you may be on the cutting edge of being green and being lower cost and effective and safer.
Safer, and the special effects. You know how long it takes to set up some of those special effects with the lighting and stuff?
I actually do.
Yeah. This is it's 2 seconds on the remote control and you're done.
By the pool, it looks exactly like water by the pool. You want candlelight, lightning, whatever. And if you want something that we don't have, we'll make it. It's simple.
We will definitely try and swing by your booth so you can give us a little demo on this. Where are you at for those who are
C8228 in the Central Hall.
Okay, I was just going to say, I haven't learned the floor plan of all 1 million feet yet. So it's in the Central Hall. You're by the central area of the Central Hall?
If you see, there's right in front of us is a giant Fuji Tower. So if you see the giant Fuji Tower, which is extremely visible, you can come down and check out our booth.
We've actually seen the Fuji Tower. Thank you both, Irene Conrad, founder of two brilliant companies, and Stephen Grillo. It's certainly a pleasure to see them from Bright Light and the production plant in New York. Bright Shot.
Yeah.
Bright Shot. Here, let me just tattoo that on the T-shirt. I actually like the shirt. If I had a couple of those, I would remember it more often.
Okay. What size would you like?
One that fits this frame here. I'd like that size. The petite. I'm Kurt Kelly from Actors Report and Live Video Inc. We are at the NAB 2012 in Vegas. What stays here is actually going to go around the world. We're going to give it up.
It's on YouTube already right now.
Yeah. It's probably on your iPhone. Just keep looking. We'll be back soon with more and hopefully see you again soon.
Yes.
Thank you.
Awesome.
What a pleasure. Thank you.
Now, what we'd like you to do is I'm going to step off set.
Yeah.
You can either do it together or you can do it separately, whichever you're comfortable.
Okay.
Or do both. Your name, your company, a little spiel or something, and you're going to be back with more with Kurt Kelly and Actors, Reporter, and Live Video Inc.
No problem.
Now that your brain is floating, have fun.
We rolling?
Yes, we are.
How you doing today? Try that again. 1, 2, 3. How you doing today? My name's Steve Grillo. I am the promotion director of Brightshot.com. I'm here with Irene Conrad, who is the
owner of Brightshot.com.
And we are here at the 2012 NAB convention promoting our brand new LED light that is going to change the lighting industry. We have developed a light that runs on 3.8 amps that does not have any heat to know about.
What else do we have?
How can I say anything more with him here? He's the best promotions guy in the business.
So our light is a workhorse. It's not about what the light does. It's about what the light is. It is the future of lighting. It is going to change how they light sets, how they light studios, and it is so green. Not only does it have green built into it, but it is green to the fact that you don't use as much electricity. You don't burn your air conditioner as much. You're saving a whole lot on crew and man hours. And we are here at the NAB in the Central Hall.
It's C8228. Please come by. We'd love to see you.
Of course, if you're watching this next week, it doesn't matter. So anyway, I want to say right now, we'd like to welcome our host,
Kurt.
Kurt, with Actors Reporter. Yes, what's his name? Kurt, well, he turned around. I couldn't see his damn badge.
Hey, that guy.
Kurt, from the NAB convention.
Hey, I like light shots. Those are really nice devices. Light shots.
I got him back from a little remark before. We're even now, pal. Here he is, the man. Carp.
Great. Thank
you.
Cut out my part. Just put him in.
No,
part.
Why?
No, you were good.
Now, he wants to do some bumpers with each of you separately, okay. Where you're just your name okay. And company, and you're watching Exodus Recorded.
Actors report. Okay. Kirk Kelly. Can't forget that. Yeah. Yeah. Actors reporter Kirk Kelly. Actors reported live anyway. Hi, I'm Steve Grillo here at the 2012 NAB convention. I am with Brightshot.com. I'm their promotions director, but you are watching Kirk Kelly at ActorsReporter.inc. ActorsReporter.inc. LiveVideoInc.com. I'm Steve Grillo. I'm here with Brightshot.com. We are the owners of the Luminator at the 2012 NAB convention. You're watching your host, Kirk Kelly, on ActorsReporterLive.com.
Actors Reporter Live Video
Inc. Live Video Inc. Why can't I get that?
No, no.